गुड मॉर्निंग मैम.
गुड मॉर्निंग. Roll number 1, yes ma'am. 2, present ma'am. 3, roll number 3, roll number 3, 4,
present ma'am.
5,
present ma'am.
6,
present ma'am.
7,
present ma'am.
8,
present ma'am.
9,
present ma'am.
10,
present ma'am.
11,
present ma'am. Present ma'am.
12,
present ma'am.
12,
present ma'am.
13, present ma'am.
14, roll number 14. Fifteen.
Present ma'am.
16.
Present ma'am.
17.
Present ma'am.
18. Roll number 18. 19.
Present ma'am.
20.
Present ma'am.
21.
Present ma'am.
22.
Present ma'am.
23.
Present ma'am.
24.
Present ma'am.
25.
Present ma'am.
26. 27.
Present ma'am.
28,
present ma'am.
29,
present ma'am.
30,
present ma'am.
31,
present ma'am.
32, roll number 32. Roll number 32. 33,
present ma'am.
34,
present ma'am.
35,
ma'am.
36,
present ma'am.
37,
present ma'am.
38.
Present ma'am.
39.
Present ma'am.
40.
Present ma'am.
41.
Yes ma'am.
42.
Yes ma'am.
43.
Present ma'am.
44.
Yes ma'am.
45.
Yes ma'am.
Roll again calling. Ma'am. Roll number 3.
Present ma'am.
Roll number 14. Roll number 14. 14. Absent. Roll number 32. Roll number 32. Who is roll number 32? It is showing here 45 total. But I am getting absent 2. 14 and 32. Roll number 14. Roll number 32. So 14 and 32 absent. So roll number 32 and 14 absent, okay? Roll number 14 and roll number 32. Just a minute, students. Again, I'm calling. Someone extra is here. Roll number 1, Kunal Kesh.
Yes, ma'am.
Roll number 2.
Present, ma'am.
Just a minute. Okay. Shobhan Nayak.
Yes, ma'am.
Give again present, Shobhan Nayak.
Yes, ma'am.
Achha, can you anyone say, tell me who is that extra one? Because I'm getting 2 absents today, but it is showing participants total 45. How is it possible?
Ma'am, as you have shared the screen, so that is why it is showing 2.
Which one?
Miss, as you have shared the screen, so that is why it is showing 45.
Ma'am, aapne do baar join kiya hai.
हमने
यस मैम व्हेन यू शेयर द स्क्रीन इट शोस दैट यू हैव जॉइंड टू टाइम्स
ओके 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 सो 2 पर्संस आर हियर ना ओके देन ओके नाउ शेयरिंग स्क्रीन इज विजिबल
यस मैम
Now yesterday I told about calcite crystal. That is calcite crystal are transparent and colorless. And calcite is which type of crystal? Positive or negative?
Negative.
Negative crystal. It is formed from calcium carbonate. It is a rhombohedral crystal containing 6 parallelogram faces. The 2 opposite angles of each parallelogram are at 102 degree and 78 degree. The 2 diametrically opposite corners of the rhombohedron where 3 obtuse angles of 102 degree meet are called the blunt corners of the crystal. So this is about the calcite crystal. So this is not so important. Just remember about that calcite crystal. The calcite is negative crystal and it is also uniaxial crystal. Only one optic axis is there in calcite crystal. Now optic axis of a crystal is defined as a direction along which the ray will pass. If the ray will pass, there will be no double refraction of the incident ray due to the same velocity of O ray and E ray along the direction. So that I discussed yesterday about the optic axis. Now this is the optic axis direction shown. So if AB is the optic axis, then all the lines parallel to this are the optic axis of the crystal. So this is the calcite crystal, it is shown here. So if AB is the direction of the optic axis, so this is another axis, this is another axis. So all are optic axis parallel to AB. All the axes are optic axis. So this is particular direction through the crystal through which light travels, there will be no double refraction. So just read this, how optic axis is drawn. So the two diagonally opposite corners of the rhombohedron. So this is two diagonally opposite corners of the rhombohedron A and B. All the angles of the faces are obtuse. If the faces are, you can see here, this is angles are obtuse angle here. All the angles are obtuse. These are the blunt corners of the crystal. A line drawn through any of the blunt corners making equal angle with each of the three edges give the direction of the optic axis. So this is how optic axis is drawn through a crystal. Any line parallel to the optic axis also an optic axis. Now unpolarized light moving along the optic axis or parallel to the optic axis cannot be divided into ordinary ray and extraordinary ray. So the phenomena of double refraction cannot occur along the optic axis as the velocities of the two rays are same along the direction. So double refraction is not occurred there. Principal section, a plane containing the optic axis and perpendicular to the pair of opposite faces of the crystal is called the principal section of the crystal. A principal section always cuts the surface of the calcite crystal in a parallelogram having angle 71 degree and 109 degree. So the figure was given when a double refraction, the figure of double refraction was shown. There you can see the angles, if you see the figure, already note you have. So the angles are 71 degree and 109 degrees. So this, if you add these two, you will get 180 degrees. So as it is parallelogram, just go to that figure, you will get it this value, 71 degree and 109 degree. The principal section always cuts the surfaces of the calcite crystal in a parallelogram having angles 71 degree and 109 degree. Just I want to show the figure where yesterday I discussed, where in that figure I'm just going. See this angle. What is this angle? 71 degree. This is the principal section of the calcite crystal. It is 71 degree as is, this is parallelogram. So this is 109 degree, this angle, and this same, and this same. So this is the figure of double refraction. So if you add, this will be 180 degree. So this was this is the principal section of the calcite crystal. Now Nicol prism, I told you Nicol prism can be used as polarizer as well as analyzer. Now tourmaline crystal, that is natural polarizer, but Nicol prism is made artificially. So Nicol prism, it is an optical device that can produce plane polarized E-ray from unpolarized light and also has an ability to analyze the plane polarized light. In the year of 1826, William Nicol invented this device. The activity of Nicol prism is based on the principle of double refraction in an uniaxial crystal. So when an unpolarized light is incident on an uniaxial crystal, then what happens? When unpolarized light is incident on an uniaxial crystal, it splits up into two rays, O ray and E ray. By the process of total internal reflection, the O ray is somehow eliminated and E ray is transmitted through the crystal as plane polarized light. Say this is the Nicol prism. Unpolarized light is coming here. Whiteboard is visible, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So unpolarized light is coming to Nicol prism. What is this? Nicol. So this is Nicol prism. Now what will happen? As this is uniaxial crystal, so according to the property of uniaxial crystal, what will happen?
V equal to VO.
No. Along the direction of the optic axis, V equal to VO. But uniaxial crystal or biaxial crystal, but that means say it is calcite crystal. That is anisotropic crystal. Say it is anisotropic crystal. Then what will happen? In anisotropic crystal, that is unpolarized light is coming. Then what will happen?
We divert into two parts.
So if you divide, so just Nicol prism I'm showing here in this way, I'm just putting one line. So why this is the line? So this is straight line as I'm drawing by hand. So this is the problem. So this is the line here. What is happening? Actually two parts. Nicol prism is divided into two parts and some different material is placed in between this. So what is happening? First, it is divided into two rays. Okay. First, it is divided into two rays. What is happening? Say this is the O ray. So this is the dot. This is the dot. So what is this ray? And this is the arrow component. So what is the upper component? This component is? What is the name of the ray? E ray. And what is this ray?
O ray.
By the process, that means in anisotropic crystal, when unpolarized light is passing, then it is divided into two rays. Now, if both of the rays you are getting here, then is the light polarized? No, because two types of vibrations are there. So by some procedure, you have to eliminate one vibration. So that method I will discuss how it is eliminated. The O ray that is coming to this layer, it comes back in this direction by the process of total internal reflection. And here it is coated with lamp black and the O ray is absorbed here in this side. But E ray, it does not follow total internal reflection, and the light that we will get from this Nicol prism, that is totally E ray. Understand? So what is happening? First, unpolarized light is coming to Nicol prism. So in between this, in this line, this is line I have drawn because this is some another material. In this portion, it is calcite. Nicol prism is made from calcite crystal. But as a whole, it is not calcite. In between the two parts, it is something calendable, some different layer is here. So from this layer, what is happening? First, unpolarized light is dividing into two parts, E ray and O ray. But what is happening? O ray is reflected from this layer. Totally reflected from this layer and it comes in this direction. And here it is in this slide, a side is coated with lamp black. Then what will happen? O ray is coming to this direction, then in this direction, and here it is totally absorbed. So that, but E ray does not face total internal reflection. Why? I am just explaining later. So it is not facing total internal reflection, it is coming out of the crystal. And the ray that we are getting from the Nicol prism, what is the ray?
E ray.
So plain polarized we are getting. Now come here. So what is the process? The activity of Nicol prism is based on the principle of double refraction in an uniaxial crystal. So the process is the double refraction. So when an unpolarized light is incident on an uniaxial crystal, it splits up into polarized E ray and O ray. Okay. By the process of total internal reflection, using Kannada balsam layer. So this is the layer. In this direction, it is coated. Here it is different material is there, Kannada balsam. So from the Kannada balsam layer, the O ray is totally internally reflected in this direction. So the activity of Nicol prism is based on the principle of double diffraction in an uniaxial crystal. So when an unpolarized light is incident on an uniaxial crystal, it splits up into polarized E ray and O ray. Now by the process of total internal reflection from the Kannada balsam layer, O ray is somehow eliminated and E ray is transmitted through the crystal as a plain polarized light. So in this way, we are getting only one type of vibration out of the calcite crystal. That is Nicol prism is made from calcite crystal. So from Nicol prism, in this way, we can get polarized light. Now this is Nicol prism construction is basically calcite rhombohedron of length 3 times of its breadth. and the end faces are cut artificially so that the acute angles of the principal section reduce from 71 degree to 68 degree. The what are the angles of the principal section just before I discuss 71 degree and 109 degree, is it? When the figure of double refraction, you show it was shown that is it is a parallelogram and the angles are total 180 degree. One is 71 degree and another is 109 degree. But if you want to construct Nicol prism, you can't take the principal section directly. So here in that principal section, you have to cut the end faces so that the one of the acute angle, you have to reduce it to 68 degree. Now the resulting crystal, then it is cut into two portions by the plane perpendicular to both the principal section and the end faces of the rhombohedron. The cut faces are highly polished and cemented together by a layer of Canada balsam. The sides of the prism is coated with lamp black and kept covered by a brass tube. The two end faces are kept open so that light may be incident on it and the and on end faces and may emerging out of the other face. Now I'm coming to the figure. Now it is clear for you. Actually, this is the calcite crystal. This is the figure of calcite crystal. Now actually, this is the total 171 degree. It was shown the principal section. So 71 degree. And but it is end faces is cut in such a way that the angle is reduced to 68 degree. Now this is shown here. This is shown here. So this is actually total hole is calcite crystal. Now to different pace, actually the total principal section is reduced from 71 degree. You can see it is 71 degree. Initially it was C, A, A dash and C1. But C, A, but after cutting, this is the shape. C, A dash, A1 and C1 dash. Now, so angle is reduced to 68 degree. You can see from here. Now, this is the direction of the optic axis, it is shown, and this is the principal section of the calcite crystal, but the angle is changed here because the end faces are cut. Now, what is happening? These are the two faces. This is one face calcite crystal, this is also calcite crystal. But calcite, that Nicol, that principal section is cut into two pieces perpendicular to the plane. So first Nicol prism is cut into two pieces. This is the principal section, say you are taking, then it is cut along this direction, diagonally it is cut. Then two pieces of the calcite crystal are there. Then two pieces are joined. The two pieces of the calcite crystal, what are the two pieces? Say C, A dash, C1 and another piece. A dash,
A1 C1 dash.
So two pieces. So two pieces of the calcite crystal are cemented together by which? By different layer called Canada balsam layer. Why it is done? Because we have to eliminate one vibration. Because we want, why we want to construct E ray. So we want to construct polarized light. So if so, first say this is the unpolarized light. It is passing through the calcite crystal. It is dividing into rays. The dot is that is the O ray and the arrow is the E ray. Now it is shown here that it comes to the Canada balsam layer and it faces total internal reflection and it comes in this direction. And this side of the calcite crystal, it is coated with lamp black and O ray is totally absorbed in this side. But E ray does not face total internal reflection. It comes in this direction and we are getting the plane polarized light as E ray. So this is the figure. Now you have to know what is happening. Why this is happening? Why we have introduced Canada balsam layer? So I'm just going here to the figure. Now the refractive index of calcite crystal for O ray is 1.66. So calcite crystal, so what is the material here? It is calcite, is it? I'm just going to the this one, another. Say I'm giving some different name, okay? Not will match with your that is given in that figure. Now this is unpolarized light. Now, so along this, so say I'm just drawing in this way because it is some different layer actually. What is that layer?
Canada.
But different material, okay. This is different material. But here in this portion, ADC, in this portion, that is calcite crystal. And in this portion, it is also calcite crystal, but it is different in middle. Now, the refractive index of ORA, mu O, is 1.66. Mu O. What is this? 1.66. What is mu O?
1.6.
Refractive index.
Refractive index of ORA. Where? In calcite crystal. Okay. Refractive index of ORA in calcite crystal, this is 1.66. And refractive index of ERA in calcite crystal, what is this? Mu E. What is this? The value is 1.49. See. So mu O is the refractive index of ORA. Where? In calcite crystal. Mu is what? Say. Refractive index of?
ERA.
In calcite crystal. Where? In calcite crystal. Because Nicol prism is calcite crystal. So it is calcite here. So here in this portion or in this portion, the refractive index of ERA is 1.49 and mu O is 1.66. And the refractive index of Canada balsam layer is 1.55. Mu Cb means Canada balsam. That is what? 1.55. Understand? Mu Cb means what? Refractive index of? Say?
Canada balsam layer.
What is this? 1.55. Okay. Okay. Now, when the consider for ORA, what is happening? ORA, what is the condition for total internal reflection? Say, first condition is what? I said that ORA faces total internal reflection and it is comes in this direction. Now, what are the two conditions of total internal reflection? Light will go from which medium to which medium?
Denser to rarer.
Yes. So, it will go from denser medium to rarer medium. Okay. So, ORA, consider for ORA. I'm considering ORA. So, for ORA, what is the refractive index here in calcite?
1.66.
So, ORA is going from refractive index 1.66 to where?
1.55 Canada balsam layer.
Okay. So 1.66 to 1.55. So denser medium to rarer medium. Okay. So ORA is going from denser medium to rarer medium. So first condition is satisfied for the total internal reflection. Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
And the second condition is what? When the angle of incidence of ORA is greater than the critical angle of the ray, the ray is totally internally refracted. Okay, this is the second condition. So if that two conditions are satisfied, then ORA, it comes, faces total internal reflection and it comes in that direction. So for this, the angle of incidence here in this direction, it will be particular. So it was shown in the figure in there. So it was shown here, this angle. Okay, you can see. If this is the angle of incidence, then it will face total internal reflection, because maybe that for condition of total internal reflection, ore is going from denser medium to rarer medium, so it faces total internal reflection. But second condition may be satisfied, may not be satisfied. If the critical, it depends on the critical angle. Now we have observed that if the critical, if the angle of incidence is like this, then here we are getting the totally internally reflected ore. So ore that faces total internal reflection and it comes in this direction, and it comes in this direction. But E ray, consider E ray. E ray is going from which medium to which medium? E ray.
Rarer to denser.
Rarer to denser. So no chance for total internal reflection. So it doesn't come in this direction. It just passes. So the refracted ray. So the refracted ray that we are getting from Nicol prism. What is this ray? E ray.
E ray.
And this light is polarized. This light is polarized. So this is the artificially made. I told you that is tourmaline crystal is natural crystal, but Nicol prism is artificially made as a polarizer. So these are the why. Now it is clear why this material is introduced here, because for to eliminate this ore. So this is the. So this is the principle of the Nicol prism. Now it is clear for you. The activity of Nicol prism is based on the principle of double refraction in an uniaxial crystal. So when an unpolarized light is incident on an uniaxial crystal, it splits up into two rays, O ray and E ray, by the process of. You can also write here anisotropic medium in uniaxial crystal. It may be biaxial crystal. Double refraction also occurs. But particular along this that axis of optic axis, you will not get double refraction. But except in that two directions for biaxial crystal, you will get double refraction. Also for uniaxial crystal, along as there is only one optic axis, so only in that direction you will not get E ray and O ray. But in other directions you will get. So you may also write here. Anisotropic medium. Unpolarized light is incident on an anisotropic crystal. Now here, though this is the principle of Nicol prism, and this, if it is given, just draw this figure and just explain it. So it is given for the total internal reflection for ordinary ray, the angle of incidence in the Canada balsam layer must be greater than the critical angle, and this will only happen when the angle of incidence of the ray on the end faces does not exceed 14 degrees. So this is important. So if it is not satisfied, you will not get the second condition of a total internal reflection. So in this way, plane polarized E ray is produced through the Nicol prism, eliminating O ray from the unpolarized light. Now Nicol prism as an analyzer. So up to this, I have discussed Nicol prism as polarizer. Now analyzer. Suppose a plane polarized light with its direction of vibration of amplitude A makes an angle theta with the principal section of the Nicol prism. Okay. What we are considering? A plane polarized light. One polarized light is coming to which? Nicol prism. And the polarized light has amplitude. What is the amplitude of the polarized light? A. So we are considering that polarized light is coming to Nicol prism, and the amplitude of the polarized light is A, and that light makes an angle theta with the principal section of the Nicol. Now A cos theta component is parallel to the principal section, will be transmitted as E ray, and A sin theta component perpendicular to the principal section will behave as O ray and will be cut off by total internal reflection. So E ray has amplitude, we can say E ray has amplitude A cos theta. And what is the amplitude of O ray?
A sin theta.
A sin theta. So if any Nicol prism is there, if it is said that mathematical also problem you can get, plane polarized light is coming, say, to Nicol prism, then the amplitude is A. Now, if it that light makes an angle theta with the principal section of the Nicol, then A cos theta will behave as E ray and A sin theta will behave as O ray. and it will be cut off as total internal by the total method of total internal reflection. Initially I was discussing that if it is unpolarized light. Now here what it is, because Nicol prism can be used as analyzer. Now it can analyze the light. Light is polarized or unpolarized. Now what will be the type of the light? It is polarized light or unpolarized light? Nicol prism can also detect. So it is used as analyzer. So I am considering initially the figure that was I was discussing, that is unpolarized light was coming to the Nicol prism, and then we are getting E ray as plain polarized light. Now here what we are considering, we have plain polarized light because say one light, we don't know what is the type of the light. It is passing through the Nicol prism and we are getting some observation. So the light may be polarized or unpolarized. So the theories I am discussing here, that if a plain polarized light with its direction of vibration of amplitude A makes an angle theta with the principal section of the Nicol, then A cos theta component parallel to the principal section will be transmitted as E ray, and A sin theta component will be behave as O ray, and between this will be eliminated. Now if the Nicol is rotated with incident ray as the axis theta will change. Now the Nicol we are rotating the Nicol. Now that theta will change. Now when theta equal to zero, that is the principal section of the Nicol is parallel to the vibration of the incident light, then the amplitude of the transmitted component is maximum. Now just I am again going here. Say one light is coming and this is the vibration, understand, this is the vibration and it has amplitude A. What is this vibration? This is polarized light, is it polarized light symbol?
Yes.
Now say this is the principal, this is the axis. This is the axis of the actually now what is shown here, I mean that what I was discussing, if the Nicol is rotated with the incident ray as the axis, theta will change. That is the principal section of the Nicol is parallel to the vibration of the incident light. Now say I'm just writing, and that means it is difficult to draw here. Say I am just drawn like this and it is passing, then what will happen? Now what will happen? Say the principal section of the Nicol, it is parallel to this light. That means theta equal to zero. What is the meaning? Principal section of the Nicol is parallel to the vibration of the incident light. So this is the direction of vibration of the incident light. This is the direction of the vibration. Say the principal section of the Nicol prism. Now this is parallel to this light. That means what is the in that condition? What is theta equal to what? Say what is theta equal to zero. So the principal section of the Nicol prism and the direction of vibration of this light, they are parallel to each other. So the value of theta is zero. And if I rotate this Nicol prism, now this theta will change. If I rotate this Nicol prism, then the theta will change. Now this direction of the vibration of the incident light and the Nicol prism, the principal section of the Nicol prism, if they are perpendicular to each other, then theta equal to what? Theta equal to 90 degree. Then 90 in that degree. Condition, theta equal to 90 degree. Okay. Now, so theta equal to 90 degree, the amplitude of the transmitted component is zero. So what is the intensity of the what is the amplitude of the transmitted component? Actually E ray has amplitude what?
A cos theta.
a cos theta. So the light actually what we get from a Nicol prism, that is a cos theta. Now theta, this theta, when this ray and this principal section, this is parallel, then the theta equal to zero, then a cos zero means a. So amplitude is what? Then a. So this is maximum. And when theta equal to 90 degree, then what will happen? When theta equal to 90 degree, then what is the amplitude here?
Zero.
A cos 90, that means zero. So if we rotate the Nicol prism, if we rotate the Nicol prism, the intensity is varying from maximum to zero. The intensity is varying to what? Maximum to
zero.
So maximum to zero. So what is our conclusion? Our conclusion is that we don't know this light. What is the type of this light? Say unknown light. Say this is unknown. K-N-O-W-N. This is unknown light. We don't know the type of the light. We have one Nicol prism. Now what we are doing? We are rotating this Nicol. We are rotating this Nicol prism. Then what will happen? What we will get? Intensity, the field of view will be maximum, and we will get variation of intensity. Some unknown light is coming, we are rotating the Nicol, then our observation is that field of view is totally bright one time and it is diminishing the total intensity, and at a time we are getting zero intensity. So our conclusion is what? Our conclusion is the unknown light is what? Polarized light. Understand? So if any polarized light is passes through any Nicol prism, we are rotating the Nicol, our observation will be the field of view. This is the field of view. Field of view will be maximum bright one time, and again when we are rotating it, then it will decrease, the intensity will decrease, and one time it will be zero. So maximum to zero intensity it will vary. Understand? So this is the conclusion. The light is polarized light. If we are getting this type of conclusion, we will conclude the light is polarized light. So read it very carefully, this portion. This is written in detail. That when theta equal to 90 degree, the amplitude of the transmitted component is zero and the field of view will be dark. For unpolar, now this is for the polarized light. Now here, for unpolarized, for any position of the Nicol, the vibration of the incident light can be resolved into two components with respect to the principal section. Parallel component will pass, but the perpendicular component will be diffused. So the field of view of Nicol will always remain bright. So here we are getting that if unpolarized light passes through Nicol prism, we are rotating the Nicol, the field of view will be, the intensity here will change with maximum to zero. But if we have unpolarized light, it is passing through the Nicol prism, we are rotating the Nicol, though the field of view will be with constant intensity. No variation of intensity you will get. So then the light is unpolarized light. So actually, you know, when the unpolarized light passes through any polarizer, if I0 is the intensity of the unpolarized light, after passing through the polarizer, the intensity becomes I0 by 2. So half. So always it is half. So here, this is the conclusion. In this way, Nicol prism can be used as analyzer. For unpolarized light, it passes through the Nicol prism, we are rotating the Nicol, the field of view will be constant with constant intensity, same intensity. But if we have polarized light, then we are rotating the Nicol, the field of view will be with maximum intensity one time, and the intensity will gradually decrease, and at last it will be zero. So in this way it will vary. Okay. I will ask these questions tomorrow. I can ask to anyone. So just prepare and then come. So this is parallel and cross Nicol. This is the figure. So this is the Nicol prism. In this way, it is shown here. So in this one, parallel here, just cutting this Kannada balsam layer, it is shown here in this way. So two Nicol prisms are there. They are parallel Nicols. That means they are kept, principal sections are kept parallelly of the tunicles. You can see the field of view is bright. You are getting light here. But if the two nicoles are crossed position, that means perpendicular to each other. The principal sections of the nicole, they are perpendicular to each other. That first unpolarized light is coming. Then it is dividing into two parts. This part is eliminated. E ray is coming out of the first nicole. Then this nicole, it is passing through this. But as the angle is 90 degree, so this ray, it is changing to O ray. And E ray, it is not passing actually. The ray, it was E ray, but it is passing, it is as it is. But here, as the angle is 90 degree, so this E ray is just converting as O ray here. So it is totally internally reflected. So this is cross nicole. If it is given, if the two nicoles are in cross position, what will be the field of view? What will be the field of view? Say.
Zero.
Zero.
That means totally field of view is totally dark. Field of view is dark. But here, the parallel nicoles, the field of view is bright. Remember this one, this figure. I'm just giving this total PPT. I will discuss retardation plates tomorrow. Some problems with the retardation plate as the time is almost over. So I'm not discussing much. So halfway plate and quarter wave plate, retardation plate, I will discuss tomorrow. Okay. So ending my class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.